In this video, I'm going to give you a great workout that you can do while you're on a cruise ship. Now, your first response may be, I'm on vacation. I don't want to work out. If that's your response, then something is wrong with your workouts. If you're dreading them that much, workouts should be fun. They should be enjoyable. It's not a checkbox. So if you're not enjoying your workouts, you need to re-examine your goals and come up with a better workout that you do enjoy. So enough of that. Now you might say, well, I've heard it's good to take a week or two off from lifting a year, and vacation is a good time to do that. Well, yes and no. I prefer to use injuries as my resting from working out. You can't control when those happen. You know, you get the flu, you can't work out. There's your rest from working out. You'd feel stupid if you took 2 weeks off while you're on vacation and then you get home and have the flu and need to take 2 more weeks off. So I say work out when you're on vacation. Not only that, it's a great chance to really mix up your workout because you're in a completely different environment and you have lots of time. You're not rushed. So work out while you're on the cruise ship. Now let me show you a workout. Now, one thing you're going to find in most cruise ships is that the gyms are pitifully small for the number of people on the ship. This ship has 4,000 people on it, and yet the weight room, the free weight area, is literally like 10 feet by 10 feet, 3 meters by 3 meters. To work out in an environment like this, you have to be incredibly flexible in what you're doing. Also, I would strongly recommend that you bring on a suspension trainer, either the $200 TX or the $5 SRX that I've shown you how to make, and some resistance bands, because then you can work out in your room, on the deck, anywhere. It lets you have a lot more options. So this workout is going to be 4 supersets of 3 exercises each. I'm going to start out in the gym because it's actually empty here, but it's going to fill up and the later supersets will be up on deck. So in this first superset, it's going to be one-armed incline dumbbells, weighted push-ups, and an incline dumbbell triceps press. Now I've showed you how to do the one-arm incline press before. Really important is that you start light. If you're not used to this torque on your core, it's easy to pull a rib muscle. And if you've ever pulled a muscle in your rib cage, you know it's probably the most painful tiny injury you could have. Breathing hurts, laughing hurts. So anyway, now without any rest, we're going to go into weighted push-ups. Have somebody put a plate on you. The 45-pound plate is convenient to use. I wouldn't use more than that. I wouldn't try stacking more on it because it's likely to slide off. Just do more reps with the 45-pound plate. And to get off, what I do, I just lay flat down on my belly and then roll over to the side. That dumps it. Okay, now for the last exercise in this superset, we're going to do an incline triceps press with a dumbbell. Great exercise, easy to get in out of, as long as what you do, you put it on your knees to get it up, kick it up till it's sitting on top of your chest, and then you can get it into position. You reverse that to get it down. Anything else is awkward and dangerous. So that's how you do it. Now, next superset, again, is going to be this asymmetrical stuff that I want. It's a one-armed bench press. Now, unless you're really good, you're going to need to do this on a Smith machine. I would not recommend it on a normal bench press. So we're going to do as many reps as we can with one hand, and then switch and do as many reps as we can with the other hand. Again, start light on this because it puts a lot of torque on your core and you do not want to have a tear in your rib cage muscles again because it's really, really painful. Make sure to spread your legs so you don't like flip over. like a bug on your back, and make sure to use the safety catches. Now, without any rest at all, we're going to go into tricep kickbacks, and we're going to do as many as we can with one hand, switch to the other hand. The third exercise we're going to do in this superset is dumbbell flies. Now, you can do these on a bench if you want. As you know, I love doing things on the floor because I think they're safer and it helps to limit your range of motion to something that's safe. Also, a lot of times in gyms, the benches are taken. So it's much easier to grab some floor space than it is to grab a bench. Now, about this time, the gym was getting really busy. So the rest of the supersets we're going to do up on deck using resistance band and TRX, or SRX, if you made your own for $5. Okay, third and fourth superset we're going to do up on deck. Most cruise ships have a running track on them. There's very few that don't. And a lot of times there's a workout equipment up there, which makes a great attach point for your resistance bands. Plus, it's nice, fresh air while you're working out. So this third superset, we're going to start off with front raises and side raises using a resistance band. And we're going to put the resistance band under our foot when we're doing it. That's just the easiest way to do this. Resistance bands are awesome because they're inexpensive and fit in your luggage, and they come in all different strengths. So grab a couple, put them in your suitcase, and you can do almost any exercise with them. I love these resistance bands. You saw used in Burma also. So next exercise in the superset is going to be for triceps. We're going to do a resistance band triceps press, one arm at a time. Now, for this, you can tie it onto a railing, or you see here I have it tied onto this funky piece of exercise equipment that I have no idea what it does. But tying onto a railing is much easier. You know, on a balcony is a perfect place to do it. It's a great triceps exercise. When you're doing this, try to make sure that your elbow does not move up and down. Keep your elbow stationary. Otherwise, you're working out your shoulders, and we want this to be triceps. Typically, it takes a much stronger resistance band for triceps because people's triceps are much stronger than their shoulders because of the small muscle. The third exercise in this superset is going to be a resistance band military press. Great exercise for shoulders. We're going to put the end of the band under our foot and then press up. It's just like using a dumbbell. Except the thing that's nice, it's easy down here. It gets harder up at the top. So it's different. So it's a great way to mix up your workout if you've only done free weights for shoulders, because it gets really hard at the end. Great exercise. Okay. The last superset, we're going to use a suspension trainer here. We're going to do a push-up with our feet elevated. This is a great way to make them a little tougher to do. When you're doing the push-ups, I like to do them on my fists because a lot of people, like myself, do not have the flexibility to do it on the palms without damaging the wrist. So I do them on the fist. Do them how you want them. Make sure you're not sagging. Don't let your butt sag. That's hard on your back. It's a little tricky to get out of. Now, the second exercise in the superset is going to be for triceps. There just happen to be dip bars here, so I'm doing dips. But you could do these dips from the suspension trainer as well. There's no reason you can't do them. It's actually hard on the suspension trainer because you got a lot of stabilizing muscles to do it at the same time. Now, the third and final exercise is cheating a little bit. It's not really shoulders. It's more upper back. It's a bit of shoulders, but it's traps too. It's a resistance band shrug from a railing. A really great exercise. Make sure to pull out as well as back when you're doing it. And keep those shoulders packed. By the way, that's the shadow of my husband there who's doing the filming. So I've shown you four supersets, and each one has three exercises in it. So that's a total of 12 exercises. Now, each of those supersets, you're going to do three rounds of it without any rest between. So that's going to mean a total of 36 sets, with the only rest being what it takes you to reset up the equipment and bands for the next superset. So that's a really efficient workout, but you know, it does not diminish your intensity because you do a pec exercise followed by tricep followed by shoulder. You're not doing two pec exercises in a row. So you're done with your workout. What are you gonna do now? I strongly suggest you head down to the buffet and have a nice protein-rich meal, small meal. You're on a cruise ship. You can have as many small healthy meals as you want. So have a nice meal, you know, walk around, hang out by the pool, and then I would suggest you get your cardio. Every day you should get your cardio. There's no reason. You have plenty of time. Now, most cruise ships have incredible numbers of treadmills and stationary bikes. It's crazy because most of the time they have a great running track, and why be inside when you can be out on this beautiful running track? So I would suggest running. If your knees can't handle it or joints, then obviously, you know, do your cardio indoors, something low impact like the stationary bike or the elliptical machine. But I love running on deck. I would recommend not running 2 days in a row because that's asking for overuse injuries. So try to alternate something low impact like stationary bike with the running. So that is it, my cruise ship workout. Again, a cruise ship is a great time to mix up your workout, try some different things, and to have leisurely fun workouts to get you reinvigorated for working out and help hone your goals too. So please don't use cruises as an excuse not to work out. Because if you need an excuse, something is wrong. Figure out what's wrong with your goals and your motivation if you dread workout so much that you're going to skip it on vacation. And on that cruise ship, do not depend on having a big gym like you have at home. If you want a great gym like you have at home, stay home. The cruise ship gym is going to be small. The dumbbells are going to be lighter than you want. They're not going to have a squat rack. I mean, think about it. You're in a ship that rolls at sea. Squatting is not a safe activity. And they're not going to have heavy dumbbells either, so for the same reason. So bring your suspension trainer. Bring your resistance bands so that you can have great workouts, even if the gym is busy or cruddy. That is it for this week. Thanks for watching. Auf Wiedersehen.